Hi, welcome back. This is our second video. Today we're gonna draw a Ninja Turtle. So this is a drawing that I got off of Instagram. And right now, I'm gonna find the center of my page. I'm using a cardstock that's a packing, and it's about the size of a comic book. And I'm gonna start by drawing some basic shapes. Gray alcohol marker and double lines. I see a square or rectangle object. And I see a handle. These are alcohol permanent markers. Two light sources in my reference. There's a light source coming from this angle, and there's a light source coming from the other angle, and they're both kind of in the frame on the subject matter and coming from behind the subject matter because there's a dark shadow. Some boxy shapes going on for some pouches, some drawstrings. Buckles and clasps and stuff here. Some I just need these chains here. There's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 links. Maybe 6. I just need 3 lines. These dark areas with some hatch work. Do some double lining. Now I'm gonna start to draw the arms and the legs. But first, I'm gonna draw the weapons. And that's gonna help me kind of size everything up too. Kind of step back and stare at it, but it's hard. Gonna shade in heavy black area. These heavy black areas and little etching coming off of them where there's little blank spaces and high contrast. In comic book style art, this is probably known as hard line. little bit of gray because I'm going to go over it with black. I want to have a little bit of gray in between. Really need to shade this area, so I'm gonna do double line work around here. Mark it off with some X's. Check like the high contrast zone over here. I didn't really need to shade this part because it's kind of black. I want to mark it. Bit of white in the middle. Just right here and there. I'm just gonna try to use the this tip and kind of carve some lines. Yep, and that works. So I'm careful. Just do some gentle kind of gestural drawing of a figure. Ninja Turtle figure. It's a real simple kind of figure. And it's basically a stick person with a little bit of roundness to them. In a shell. In a half shell. usually I draw on an easel, or I'll tape my drawings to the wall sometimes if I don't have an easel. I want to practice drawing with my back straight and sit in a chair with no back. If you draw a lot over time, like me, your back can start to do some crazy stuff. Mostly just hurt a lot. But it hurts worse than it is. As long as you practice. Some things that help me practice are drawing with a chair with no back, standing up straight, stopping every now and then to stretch. I don't have time right now because this video is short. Since it's smudging, since it's real wet, I'm gonna try to work all from left to right so that I can show you how I'm drawing. But since my wrist smudged a little bit, like, I gotta do it in a way that I won't, so I'm gonna start doing. But you can do it from bottom up, that will help too. So I'm gonna do a little bit of both. So I'm gonna go up my legs, and do some kind of skinny, stay real close to the edge, be careful, don't do what I just did, color in the wood, this probably scratchy line. Wait for that to dry. It only takes a couple seconds because I got a lot of black. Got some smudging going on. Hold it down and start drawing a patch. Patchwork. Now there's some hard lines and a little bit of edge. So just go right up next to your blacks and throw these little edge marks. Some cross hatching if you want to. barely enough. The light source has to be coming from an odd place, like behind the figure, such as barely catch the edge of an object just right to make a little bit of high contrast light zone. Where you have a heavy dark area, then you have an odd light source coming from maybe a weird light source, like under him. And it's catching light just right, so. And I have him standing on top of a building in my reference. Turtles got like little dots on their green skin sometimes. Thank you. thanks for